Thanks for joining us here at KARE11.com. I'm Alicia Lewis. We start our top headlines with the latest in the race for the White House. Candidates on both sides of the aisle continue to make stops in battleground states. Our Audrey Russo shows us their strategies.
Day three on the campaign trail, and Governor Walz's Midwest appeal is really having a moment. The Harris campaign is trying to capitalize on that. They did so yesterday, holding two rallies in both Wisconsin and Michigan. At the same time, the Republican vice presidential candidate, J.D. Vance, senator from Ohio, held dueling rallies in the same cities at pretty much the same time. Both campaigns are trying to fine-tune their attacks, focusing on issues like abortion, gun control, crime. Senator Vance actually zeroed in on Governor Walz, and specifically Governor Walz's 24 years of military experience with the National Guard. Vance criticized past comments made by Walz about carrying weapons during war. Walz's time in the National Guard did not involve combat. Take a listen.
He has not spent a day in a combat zone. What bothers me about Tim Walz is the stolen valor garbage. Do not pretend to be something that you're not.
At 17, I joined the Army National Guard. For 24 years, I proudly wore the uniform of this nation.
That back and forth is likely to continue as, of course, the campaign trail never sleeps. The Harris campaign is set to do another rally later this week in Battleground, Arizona. One noticeable absence from the Vance rallies, though, is the person who's at the top of the ticket, former President Donald Trump. He is set to hold his own rally in Montana, and that's going to happen on Friday. Back to you.
Happening today, a metro area youth volleyball coach will appear in court after being accused of sexually assaulting minors. A federal grand jury indicted former Maple Grove High assistant volleyball coach Dorian Bars on 9 counts of child pornography and coercing minors. According to the indictment, Bars used Snapchat, text messaging, and other means to engage female minor victims in sexually focused conversations and also coerce victims to engage in sexual activity. Bars could enter his plea in court today. Minneapolis police are looking for a man suspected of setting 5 fires in Uptown. One of them was at a building where 10 people were sleeping inside. This is surveillance video of the suspect starting the fire. 4 businesses in that same building were at least temporarily displaced. Prosecutors have not said if they believe the businesses were specifically targeted.
We had people sleeping upstairs. We had about 10 residents that were sleeping upstairs at the time of the arson fire. So thank God nobody was hurt. But yeah, it was a serious fire, probably about $500,000 in damage. So it's, it was a big deal for us.
According to the criminal complaint, 62-year-old Bennett Thomas was immediately arrested and even confessed, but he was not immediately charged. Now there is a warrant for his arrest. Well, the fallout continues following the sudden closure of Rainbow Health in Minneapolis, and today workers will be sharing their frustrations. The workers say facility leaders canceled a bargaining session planned for today, meant to discuss the impacts of the closure on the staff. The union says their contract requires a month notice for layoffs, but they claim they found out hours before. In a statement on their website, the board says the operation was no longer sustainable. A state Supreme Court ruling is upholding the voting rights for thousands of felons. The Restore the Vote law, passed in 2023, automatically grants a felon the right to vote once they're released, even if they're on probation. Opponents said the law violates Minnesota's constitution. The state's high court ruled the plaintiffs weren't directly impacted, so they didn't have a standing to sue. Latest numbers show a drop in Americans filing for new unemployment benefits last week, leading to a higher open on the stock market. The Labor Department report shows jobless claims fell by 17,000 last week. Numbers are still slightly elevated, but are no longer at concerning levels. The weekly unemployment claims are often considered to serve as a representation of the number of layoffs the country is seeing. 2 people are in police custody suspected in an alleged terror plot at a Taylor Swift concert in Austria. Police believe the target was the Eras Tour concerts planned for Thursday, Friday, and Saturday in Vienna, all of which been canceled. Police say a 19-year-old suspect had pledged an oath to ISIS, and they believe both men were radicalized on the internet. A concert promoter says ticket holders will get automatic refunds. All right, closer here to home, the Minnesota Zoo is reviewing its policies after a training issue led to the death of an owl. Here's what happened.
I'm Morgan Wolf. A new report sheds light on how an owl at the Minnesota Zoo escaped its handler and was later eaten by a tiger. Zoo officials say that the Eurasian eagle owl got away from its handler during a training exercise in April and then flew into the tiger habitat. An inspection report by the USDA says that handling of all animals during training sessions should be done in a manner that does not cause trauma or physical harm to the animal. In 2021, something similar happened when a same type of owl flew out of the Minnesota Zoo and then was found injured on the side of the road. The zoo says that animal welfare is a top priority and they are closely working with its free flight bird training partner to review its policies, adding that the specific owl in this incident was at the beginning stages of its training and still adjusting to the zoo.
There's more changes coming to the state fair this year, including the price of milk. Midwest Dairy announced this year it's going to cost you $3 to get a bottomless cup from the iconic all-you-can-drink milk stand. That's up from $2, proving even one of the best deals at the Minnesota State Fair isn't immune to inflation. It's the first price hike in almost a decade. When the stand started in 1955, it cost just a dime. When it comes to NFL stadiums, U.S. Bank is considered one of the best. That's according to a study by sportsbook site NJBet. The home of the Vikings ranked fifth in the nation behind Atlanta, Baltimore, Detroit, and Seattle. The stadiums were ranked based on accessibility, affordability, fan feedback, and their location. Over the last few days, the internet's been speculating about who's going to play Governor Tim Walz on Saturday Night Live. Steve Martin was one actor a lot of people were suggesting, but we're now learning that he has reportedly turned down the offer. In an interview with the LA Times, Martin says he told the creator of SNL that he's not an impressionist and he'd struggle to do that. We could have an answer, though, by the end of next month, because Saturday Night Live returns on our televisions September 28th. Looking forward to it. When you head outside for the next couple of days, it's going to be cooler than you'd expect for August, that is. But we are expecting the sun to stick around, so here's your forecast.
All right, sun right in the face. That's how you know it's a nice day. I can barely see you. It is a perfect day today, depending on how you define perfect, but it's going to be in the upper 60s, low 70s. Now, it comes off the heels of a fairly wet day yesterday to the north. Now, we only saw a few sprinkles here in the metro. I think the actual accumulation here in the metro was a trace. Now, when South Metro actually saw 0.05, but most of us just saw this sprinkle activity. The blue is where the bands were at yesterday, and Brainerd picked up about half an inch. Alexandria picked up half an inch. Duluth area, just less than half an inch. So there was some rain, and that is from the cold front. Now, the cold front is dropping temperatures. The 24-hour temperature change is a big drop, 3 to 14 degrees cooler at this time than it was yesterday. And yesterday wasn't the warmest day. And the reason for this is strong northwest winds at around 15 to 20 miles per hour. I think it's great. This is kind of one of those late September, early October days. You know, when you head out to the pumpkin patch, I mean, we're there, right? We're about 15 degrees off our average for this time of the year. So as you get behind this low pressure center, the low is sitting here swirling in Winnipeg, and it is taking Canadian air and driving it in behind this low pressure center. That is giving us that 15 to 20 mile per hour wind. But when you have the low set up like this, it gives you that reinforcement. So that means this is not just a small cool down. When you have sunshine at this time of the year, this is key. If it's sunny out and it's not 85, there's obviously a big change because typically the sun is going to be keeping you warm. And most of the time, most, not all, obviously, most of the time you're seeing temperatures in the 60s, it's due to a washout rain day. That is not the case here. This is abnormal. This is great. 69, we'll get a south northwest wind, like I said, all day long. We might touch 70 at around 3, 4 o'clock, and then we're going to coast. And I think by this evening, we're going to be actually chilly. We'll be in the 50s by 11 o'clock tonight. Lows are going to start pushing the 40s here. So temperatures topping out today, 60 degrees in Bemidji. Again, you got that low swirling and more cloud cover. How about 60 in Bemidji? What an afternoon. It's going to feel great. The next couple of days here, dew points are gone. Pleasant conditions with dew points in the 40s through Sunday. The whole weekend is very dry. A small uptick Monday, maybe a shower on Monday. By the time we get to Wednesday, Thursday, we will start to see humid levels return. Summer's going to come back. I don't see any warm days, but we'll get back to normal. And just getting back to normal will add some rain chances. So rain chances are off here Friday through Sunday. Monday, light rain chances, pretty low. And then by the time you get to Thursday, now we'll be talking about our real chance for rain. But that, I mean, that's a whole week. A whole week without rain is kind of what we're expecting here. High temperatures right around 70 the next 2 days. That means a lot of 60s. Fabulous weekend ahead, 73 Saturday, 78 on Sunday. Scattered showers Monday, and then next week we pop it up to 82 degrees.
Looks great. Well, that's a wrap from us here at care11.com. Have a great day.